हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेमंड फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 71। बैटल ग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया प्राइवेसी पॉलिसी हैज बीन रिलीज्ड। अकॉर्डिंग टू इट, प्लेयर्स अंडर 18 इयर्स नीड टू गेट कंसर्न फ्रॉम देयर पेरेंट्स टू प्ले दिस गेम। माइनर्स कैनॉट प्ले बैटल ग्राउंड्स मोबाइल इंडिया फॉर मोर देन 3 hours ए डे और स्पेंड मोर देन ₹7,000 फॉर इन ऐप परचेसेस पर डे। Auctions for the 5G spectrum in India are likely to be pushed to the first quarter of 2022. According to a new report, the Department of Telecom is apparently preoccupied with making sure network remains stable during the pandemic and has hence put off the decisions to spectrum availability and pricing. It is unlikely that auctions will happen this year and will get postponed. The focus currently is on keeping networks stable. The DoT had approved the first 5G trials to be held in India earlier this week. An early sale for 5G spectrum in India, since telcos will need at least 6 months to conduct 5G trials and develop local use cases. The government has not approved Chinese telecom gear makers for supplying equipment through, meaning telcos will have to go to Ericsson, Samsung, Nokia or Reliance Jio, which is developing its own technology. Asus Zenfone 8 Mini BIS certification suggests imminent launch in India. Zenfone 8 series launch date is May 12th, and the key specifications include a 120Hz AMOLED display, Snapdragon 888 processor and a 64MP rear camera, and it also has a 30W fast charging. Asus has an event scheduled for May 12th when it is expected to unveil the Zenfone 8 series. Ahead of the event, a new leak that reveals specifications for the Zenfone 8 and Zenfone 8 Flip along with the render of each device. Zenfone 8 Flip will indeed retain its flip camera, a signature feature of Zenfone 7. The motorized camera module will feature a triple camera setup including a 64MP main sensor, 8MP telephoto lens and a 12MP macro lens. Zenfone 8 Flip will reportedly feature a 6.67 inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display with a 90Hz refresh rate, and it comes with a Snapdragon 888 processor. It has a 8GB RAM and a 256GB of internal storage. WhatsApp announced its new privacy policy beginning this year, to be specific in early days of January, but unlike that the messaging platform expected, the newly updated privacy policy faced a tremendous backlash from users in India. Well, that was because in the policy, WhatsApp revealed users' details it shares with parent company Facebook, and there is a lot of them. The new WhatsApp privacy policy created a buzz in the entire country, and angry users moved to platforms such as Signal and Telegram eventually. Due to all the criticism WhatsApp received on its new privacy policy, the secure messaging platform later decided to push the deadline to accept the policy by 3 months, till May 15th, which is just a few days away. Today, it became known about the action launched by the team of the Signal Messenger. The company launched targets ads on Instagram with many different ads that shared personal information about users. This was done in order to show the data what Facebook collects about its audience. Ultimately, each user saw the basic information about himself that the social network collects and sells access to it. Thus, people could see data about their work, geolocation, personal interest, and even relationships. Gurugram District Administration on Thursday launched a dedicated WhatsApp COVID-19 helpline to provide citizen access to critical information and a critical repository of all coronavirus resources. The helpline is free to use and it is available in Hindi and English. Citizen can send hi to the number and WhatsApp to the given link in the description. Paytm wants to help the citizens in India so they can find a slot for COVID-19 vaccination in this area. As a result, the payment app has released a dedicated slot finder tool available on the service of Android and iOS applications. Paytm founder Vijay Shankar Sharma revealed the same on its Twitter account and shared that the COVID-19 vaccine slot finder will help users find slots at vaccination center in their area. The tool procures real-time data from Cowin. Cowin stands for COVID Vaccine Intelligence Network, which is India's COVID-19 vaccination program. The British Royal Navy is testing futuristic jet suit to help its marine defy gravity and fly. Like Iron Man to board ships moving at a distance, a new video by the UK-based Gravity Industries, the firm behind the suit, showed. The video showed a Royal Marine taking off from a high-speed inflatable board using this suit and then landing on the deck of the Navy's offshore patrol ship HMS Tamar. The Marine has a machine tied to his shoulders that resembles a backpack and another cylindrical pair tied to either of his hands. These machines provide him with enough thrust to launch from the speedboat, fly above the water and balance his movement. Meanwhile, he is airborne and during the landing. After he lands on the deck of HMS Tamar, the Marine throws out a rope ladder for his colleagues to climb up the ship from their boat. Twitter is introducing prompts that lets users know when they use strong language and let them review their tweets before posting them online. This new feature will be available for both Android and iOS users, and for users who use a social media platform in English, the feature works when users tweet offensive remarks, insults, or strong language that could potentially be offensive or harm someone. According to the Twitter, the social media platform tested out the feature in 2020. Microblogging site Twitter has recently introduced bigger image previews on iOS and Android. According to Mashable, the larger image previews do have their limits, though as per the Twitter, images with 2:1 and 3:4 aspect ratios will now show in full. If a user posts an incredibly tall image, it will still get cropped. Some good news awaits mobile gamers, as it seems likely the highly anticipated mobile version of Valorant is already under development. According to the reports, sources close to Riot Games have claimed that the title, which has been tentatively named Valorant Mobile, is in the works while the company analyzed the game's market. Further, according to the popular leaker, player IGN has released date of Valorant Mobile might be nearer than expected. According to him, Valorant Mobile will be announced at E3 2021, which is gonna take place around mid-June. Epic Games is planning to bring the full version of Rocket League to mobile, with a beta potentially being released in the second quarter of 2021. The upcoming release is not to be confused with Rocket League's White Swipe, which will be launched for iOS and Android mobile platforms later this year. Oppo K9 5G have been launched in China. The Oppo K9 5G specifications include a Snapdragon 768 chipset. It comes with a 8GB RAM and a 6.4-inch 90Hz AMOLED screen. We can also see 4300mAh battery that supports 65W fast charging. Oppo K9 5G price starts at ₹1,999, that is approximately 22,000 Indian rupees. Along with the Oppo K9 5G smartphone, Oppo has launched its Smart TV K9. It is available in 3 display sizes, 43-inch, 55-inch, 65-inch. Along with that, it has launched Oppo Enco Air wireless earbuds, come with a Bluetooth 5.2 and offers 24 hours of battery life. The Smart TV K9 series starts at 1799 RMB, and the Echo Air earphones also priced at 249 RMB. The Oppo foldable phone will have a 7-inch display when unfolded. Oppo is working on a foldable smartphone with clamshell design, claims a tipster. It is set to measure a 2-inch when folded and feature a high refresh rate display. Oppo could launch the foldable phone before June this year. Xiaomi earlier this year unveiled the Redmi Note 10 series in India and other markets. The smartphone series came with a value for money specifications. This include a 120Hz Super AMOLED display and a 108MP camera system, etc. However, the device lacked 5G network support. Xiaomi is now gearing up to launch the Redmi Note 10 series with 5G network support in Mexico. A tipster, Abhishek Yadav, has shared the poster suggesting that 5G variant will feature a Qualcomm Snapdragon 5G chipset. We can expect the device to come with the Snapdragon 750G processor. Other specifications are likely to remain the same. Samsung's next camera-centric flagship, tentatively called the Galaxy S22 Ultra, will have a large shoes to fill. As per the new leak, the Galaxy S22 Ultra will have one camera trick that will put it miles ahead of others: continuous zoom. Tipster Heis Universe has shared a Weibo that Samsung Electromechanics and the company's semiconductor division have jointly developed an in-house continuous zoom solution that will make its way to the upcoming phones. Lenovo had an event in China last month where it announced new Windows-powered devices. Many had expected that Chinese tech giant would announce new Android tablets, but it didn't. It is now released teaser for one of the tablets, which will launch as Xeoxin Pad Pro 2021. According to the Weibo post, the Snapdragon 870-powered Xeoxin Pad Pro 2021 will have an OLED display with a 2.5K resolution, an 800:1 contrast ratio, and a 600 nits of brightness. The teaser also confirmed the display will have a 90Hz refresh rate, HDR10, TUV Rheinland certified eye care protection, and a Dolby Vision. The forthcoming Google Pixel 6 may not feature a Snapdragon processor. Instead, it is expected to house a Google Mate chip, which is codenamed called as Whitechapel. A new evidence has been appeared to point that the Pixel 6 will be driven by the company's in-house chip. In the screenshot, it is mentioned as a Whitechapel text can be seen in the URL mentioned by one of the Google engineers in the code change submitted to the Android open source project. The publication claims that P21 mentioned by the engineer in the line, "You don't need to code name to use Blinder." Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share, and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.